say W, but eat a me more shimmy kawante ooh. Freestyle learning objectives, but you know I spit flow. Hit the switches on my office chair and watch me get low. Let me sheet check this shit and tell you how it's about to go. I do what I want, cause respect up so.
And
I can hear it now, type, save print. Here comes another fucking counseling statement. It shows on my case when I walk up in the class like
Soup J-S-I-O.
Bitch, Soup J-Pad.
Teaching to leader like
way good
at. Oh gosh, what am I trying to say?
Oh, Shili Hajiman, I'm the best in C-Bond, sir. Chillin' Hajiman when I'm slurping green monsters. What you crying for? Fuck. She looked up, stop and screaming.
He's sick, yeah.
And John about this bitch is Yi Song Hei. She needs to take a pose act like House Out Day. And chill, chillin' hot, saying hell no, who told you? I fill my water bottle with a bottle of soju. And how many bottles will you slam, nigga, nay down? How many bottles will you ram, nigga, nay down? And buy for the minors, cause they deserve to drink some. Now they're punching NCOs at the fucking Hobson. I'm reppin' KPO, man, chill back, pal. The max entity at gong pays at the state will allow. And she home, she gammin', this shit ain't hard. But I look to my right and I'm praying to God.
Something new is choppy, turn my headphones up.
계속되겠습니다.
Fuck!
Yeah. Y'all Kyopos ain't ready for this shit. Fuck em.
So, if I did it right, y'all should have heard a little ditty by my homeboy, Juan Teyu, a.k.a. Patient Zero, Aigoo Desuka. Yeah, all those. but if I didn't do it right, then you didn't hear it, so you don't know what I'm talking about. But I'll get into that. It's kind of part of the reason, or I guess the whole reason I'm doing this. Little rambling right now. So I guess to start, start a little, I guess a writing project, and then kind of turned into wanting to do sort of like a podcast, like not like a podcast. So just expression in different mediums. Anyway, so the name, I called it Hoogkin Ban Salon. Started out called Hoogkin Ban Forum, is how it started. And Hoogkin Ban Salon, I like the way that sounded better. Because I heard some British person there, like, it's not the salon, or however they talk. I gotta ask my cousins. Anyways, so I guess let me break it out. Starts out, so Hoogkin Ban. So started when I was in... taking Korean, learning Korean, learning to speak the Hanguk Mar. And so I don't know if you're unfamiliar with Koreans. I mentioned it in another. I did my solo episode on kind of MMA and combat sports and what got me into that, interested in that, spectating. But damn, I lost my train of thought already. But I, so class, yeah. So I was in a Korean class. Yeah. So I said that before, when I was younger, I didn't even know what, I mean, I knew Koreans. Because in my high school, one of my high schools, the first high school I went to, we had, I guess middle school too, we had like two pages of Lee's, which is a common Korean name. Lee, Kim, Park, all common names. But I just thought, I was like, oh, Korean, yeah, that's like some kind of Chinese or something. And fast forward to going to school to learn Korean, which partially wasn't my choice, but ended up, you know, being good for me. I ended up being like great for me, actually. But Koreans, yeah, so the teachers, Korean teachers are pretty serious. I would say that trying to think out how to describe them. I have to describe them to people as like Koreans are the Marines of Asia, especially the teachers, because they don't fuck around. No, they don't take any excuses. Like, I expect you to learn everything, anything they're teaching you. There's like, why don't you know this already? So it's a lot of fun. But yeah, so that's where Hoogkin Ban started, because so our teachers, so we had three classrooms, and the teachers rotated, and we had students in each class, and the teachers would be teaching each one. And they broke it out, I don't know how they broke it out at first, but after you take your first test, then they kind of break it out into ability groups, I guess. But it's like by your grades. So it's like there's A-Ban, C-Ban, or A-Ban, B-Ban, C-Ban. But Ban just means classroom. So if you put Ban after the word, it means class. So A-Ban is A-class, B-Ban, B-class, C-Ban, C-class. And eventually I was in C-Ban. However, I didn't have terrible grades, but we found out, everyone in C-Ban, I don't remember how far into class we were, it was the first term or semester still, but it was early. People hadn't rolled out, so rolling out, let me back up a little bit, yeah, rolling out, just for context, is, so if you do so bad, they either drop you out of class, you get kicked out if you're not performing, or you get rolled out, you get dropped into a junior class. Like, say you're in first semester, then you are like that near the end of first semester, and you're like doing bad. The teachers, they might, if you're lucky, you get rolled back into a class that's like an earlier in the semester. And if you're not lucky, you get kicked out. But so anyways, yeah. So we're I don't think any. Well, actually, I think one person had rolled out, but I'll get into that later. It's a story about Juan Tae-yu and a cat lady. But anyways, so C-Ban. So we end up in C-Ban, and we're looking around, and it's all the students that all the melanin students are in C-Ban. So we're looking around, and the gingers. There's two gingers too. Boy, my boy Dobin, and can't remember the other kid's name. We weren't friends, but speaking of rolling, he actually rolled back into our class. So he was in a class that was ahead of us, and then he wasn't performing well, and then he rolled back into our class. So it was all the black and brown students and the gingers and C-Ban. And we were looking around, we were just like, oh, interesting that we're all in C-Ban. So we started calling, as a joke, we started calling it Hoogkin Ban. Hoogkin just means, literally means black person. So like, same thing with Ban, you put it after, like C-Ban is C-class. And then for like races or ethnicities, In is like person, or I don't know why I said that with a, felt like a tone, but Koreans don't use tones, but yeah, so person, so Hoogkin is a black person, so literally, you know, the color black, and then In, so Hoogkin Ban, so the, and we were the most colorful in pigment and colorful in personality, I think, so that might have been part of why we were all in the same classroom. I have a video. I'm gonna have to put it up. The quality is bad. I recorded it. This is back before smartphones. It was when smartphones were just coming out. So I think it was actually, I might have had a BlackBerry. But I remember I got video phones, camera phones had been out only for a little bit, and then it was coming out to where you could like get on the internet, and like the first. I don't know if BlackBerries are considered smartphones or not, but remember I got a BlackBerry. The whole reason I got the BlackBerry was so that I could go on the internet and download porn. And like in between classes, I'd be downloading porn. But like that was like the, for me at the time, that was like, that was the pinnacle of technology. I was like, porn on my phone. I was a Lance Corporal at the time. Maybe I might have even been a PFC. I was a young Marine. So, I mean, that was a big deal for me. And, you know, priorities. But, so our classroom. Yeah, I have a video. It's like in, I think, 3GP or whatever that format is. And it's super grainy. You can hear the audio. I got to figure out a way to, enhance the video because of the resolution. Because, you know, the screens were so small back then. I'm sure if I could figure out a way to, because if it plays in that small format, because when I try to play it on the computer, you know, it stretches out the screen. So the resolution, it doesn't maintain the resolution, trying to expand it out. So it looks super grainy. You can still tell what's going on. So we would have stress breaks. And I'll have to figure out how to put the video up because it's funny that it's a lot more funny. It's funnier than listen. It's funny at all, but it's funny, definitely funnier than listening to me ramble about it. But it's pretty much we're just. It's not even beatbox. It's like beatboxing / scatting / just making noise, musical sounds, and everyone is just like dancing in the middle of class because we're just like, because I mean, Korean teachers are fucking intense. Oh, excuse me. yeah, they're fucking intense and no mercy at all. But so sometimes we were just like, fuck it. And we're like, stressu breaku. And then just start fucking singing and dancing or whatever. And just to break up the monotony. Because if it was up to the teachers, fucking our songsaengnim-deul, we would be in class 20, like nonstop. Like we would come in, so after a weekend, we'd come into class on Monday and they would tell us, they'd be like, oh, what did you do? What did you do over your weekend? Yeah, over the Chumal. Chal chinaseo? And we're like, oh, nay. Yeah, we did. It was a good time. We watched a movie and the teacher was like, oh, Aigoo. That's my face. I say that. It's like ingrained in me now. Like I say, Aigoo is just basically, it's like, oh my goodness, sir. It's such a wide range of it's applicable in every situation. You know, if you stub your toe, like, oh, Aigoo. If you see a car wreck, Aigoo. You know, someone scares you, you see like, you know, a chick with a nice butt or a dude with a nice butt, you're like, ooh, Aigoo. You know, someone does something nice, Aigoo. You're like disappointed. So it's a great exclamation that you can use for anything, and I do it now. Like it's stuck in my head now. Like I don't not say it. That and shiza. I say shiza a lot too. I don't know why. I pick up, you know, words and stuff. I like them. Also, zao gaolu. That's another favorite one. So zao gaolu is like Chinese, but it's the same thing for Korean. You can use it the same way. If you see, it literally means the cake's gone rotten. But so it's like, oh shit, something went wrong, kind of thing. So like, you know. Like someone's like, oh no, there was a fucking mugging outside. Like, zao gaolu. Cake's gone rotten, which is, you know, terrible, I guess, back in the day. I'm sure it's referring to rice cake, probably. Dok, dok chinen go. Anyways, yeah, that was a tangent. Oh, anyways, so yeah, the teachers will come in. Because they'd be like, oh, yeah, what'd you do over the weekend? And we're like, oh, I watched a movie. Like, oh, Aigoo, a movie? You watched a movie? You have test today. You know, study? Yeah. So they're like, something's name. Come on. Like, over the weekend? Of course we studied because we always had homework. Nonstop homework. We'd have quizzes, preview quizzes. We'd have quizzes on vocabulary that we hadn't learned yet. So, and if you failed preview quizzes, yeah, yours, they just, well, man, they love shame. Koreans love to shame people. I need to get my buddy in here and talk to him about it, because he's the, I have more than one Korean friend, but I always think that's funny when people are like, I'm not racist, I have a this friend, or I know this kind of person. No, I'm not sexist. I have sisters and a mom, like everybody does. But, yeah, my my closest in proximity Korean friend. Actually, I haven't seen him in a long time. Son of a bitch. I'm just joking. Yeonhae, young name, just a joke. But yeah, that's another thing about Korean culture that's funny. I'll get back to what I was talking about. I'll probably jump around a lot. That's just how I talk. That's how I think. I think in circles because it all connects. And I mean, kind of the whole point of my little ramble here today is that because people are always asking me, like, what is Hoogkin Ban? What is about? What's the name of it? Blah, blah, blah. Or where did the name come from? So that's what I'm explaining. All these pieces, you know? I don't speak in a straight line. You got to go in loops. That's how I think. So follow me. Or don't follow me. I mean, yeah. So I don't follow myself. It's hard to keep up. But yeah. So my buddy, got to ask him about what the deal is with the shaming. Koreans love shaming. And then, yeah, so the teachers are always rough on Mondays, on every day's preview quizzes. That's what I was talking about. So then, yeah, I guess rewind it even more. So Hoogkin Ban, would you stress breaker? And yeah, preview quizzes. So yeah, we're in there. We're in. So we started calling C Bon Hoogkin Ban. The teachers didn't think that was funny. They did not appreciate that. Now my mind blankety. Aigoo. See, there's a good place to use Aigoo. Oh, Aigoo. Yeah, I remember. There's this one chick. So they, God, son of a bitch. Sorry, technical difficulties are trying to run all this fucking equipment solo. But, yeah. Oh, excuse me. ASMR. But so there's this one chick that everyone was like singing her praises about how great she was at Korean. And she was good. She wasn't part of Korean. But anyway, they're doing a speech contest and she gets up there and she's just fucking flowing, just going, killing it. But at one point she hits a hiccup and forgets her spot. And she sounds kind of like me when I'm talking. But she hit the Aigoo perfect. She was like, blah, 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 blah. Oh, Aigoo. And I loved it. I was like, I always love a good, you know, Aigoo. But yeah, she lost the contest because of that. The teachers, they were like, they were in love with her until that happened. They were just like, no. And they, so boom, sorry. I wonder if my boy, No Joo Hyun, I wonder if he won the contest. He won everything with Korean. We did some good Korean together. Oh yeah, those will be. I need to get him in here too. Some good stories. Talk about our experience going to Korea. yeah. I'll tell some of this because this kind of goes into the idea of Hoogkin Ban. I'll tie it back to our classroom. But so he's my boy No Joo Hyun. He is from Baltimore. Fucking 6 foot, 200 pound. Just, you know, athletic brother. And except for he can't run. Hates running. He can sprint. Hates running distances. I remember when he first got to our platoon, I was like, fuck. I looked at him. I was like, this motherfucker looks athletic. I was like, because I hate running too. And I was like, fuck, he's going to make me look bad. But we went on our first run and he was just like, nah. He's like, I'm not. I'm not doing this shit. Well, I mean, obviously we had to run, but he wasn't like fucking trying to beat anyone at long distance runs. And I was talking about him, like our running joke, no pun intended, our running joke we always had was, he'd always be like, yo, my legs hurt, just like fucking randomly. So we'd always, if we were just sitting around and there's like a lull, we just look at it like, yo man, my legs hurt. But it's probably more funny to us than but anything. But so he beast. He's a beast at Korean. Probably so is. But he fucking and this is, let me say that this is how I'm gonna take credit for him being good at Korean. Cause when he first got he was in a class behind me, and then so me, our other boy, we called him Kirong. So we'll say his name is Kirong. I can't maybe Anjusok? I don't know. Nah. But anyways, Kirong. He's in a class ahead of me. So then when our boy Nojihyun started hanging out with us, we'd always he was like, oh, he wanted to, he's always just like bugging us about Korean. He's like, oh, how do you like different grammar patterns, like how do you say this, what do you say this. It got to the point where like it was fucking stupid annoying at first, but it was ended up being great, because whenever we were out, we go out, you know, fucking drinking or partying or whatever, we'd end up speaking Korean to each other. So it got to the point where we were just always like basically doing speaking practice, practicing Korean to each other everywhere we went, and especially when we got drunk. Something about drinking that makes Korean fucking flow. And I think it has to do with Korean culture, fucking, it's a drinking culture, but it's not like a sloppy, you know, fucking kind of drinking culture, I guess. I don't know. Is there a sloppy one? Are Irish people sloppy drunks? I don't know. It's the only other, and then what other drinking cultures people talk about? Russians, Germans, I guess, drinking beer. Russians with their vodka, Irish whiskey. But Koreans, Korean soju. A thing about Korea, you can buy alcohol 24 hours a day. You can drink in the streets. People, so if someone's drunk and passed out, people don't fuck with them. Like, it's a social taboo to I wouldn't say molest, but like mess with you know, drunk people on the street. Like, people would look down on someone. So there's like a drunk guy on a passed out on a bench. If you were to like slap him in the face or draw dicks on his face like people do in America, or rob him, you know what I mean, robber, rape, pillage, that would be frowned upon. Like, in America, people are like, oh, my God, they're fucking drunk, blah, stumbling around. Like, in Korea, it's like, yeah, that's just normal. Like, they have, I remember this super surreal moment, one of many. There's a group of us, we're walking through, fuck, I don't remember which, like, area or neighborhood we were in, but, so we were going to school, Kode. We did a like an exchange student study abroad type thing at Kode University, which is their Harvard, I guess. It's fucking super nice. It was, that entire experience was crazy. It was cool. But anyway, so we were there for school, and every night we'd go out and get hammered, and we're just walking around and. Just randomly, I don't think we knew where we were going. We're just walking around looking for different places to drink, and there are many. And they always have like the street stalls. Fuck, I can't remember what those are called in Korean. But you know, just go in there and they make food. It's like, oh, it's Korea's fucking amazing. But so then we turn a corner, and it's kind of like a what are those called? Like a plaza. And because it's so tall skies, there's all the buildings, tall huge buildings, and we walk, it's like we come around a corner, and it's like a plaza in a business district. So it's like the skyscraper, you know, the business buildings, they have the glass windows on the sides, you can see in the office, like office buildings. So it's, you know, it's like a square, it's like four, but it's the buildings make kind of this little area in the middle that's open, and we walk it, but there's you know those like plastic tables and chairs that people put out on like patios, or you know, you put out for barbecues or picnics or whatever. It's like rows and rows of those, and all these drunk fucking Korean businessmen. Like, they're in suit and ties. You know, their ties are loose and their jackets are off because they're getting at it. They're all fucking just slamming soju, just drinking. But that's part of the culture too, is like they'll have, I guess in America we call it like happy hours or whatever, where the senior person takes out the junior people, or the boss brings out all the, you know, junior employees. And so then the boss, you know, treats everybody, or whoever the senior person is. So that's another thing about like Korean culture, very hierarchical and very respect driven. Maybe that's kind of where some of that, all that shame stuff comes from. But it's very organized, even in the language itself, the way you speak to somebody. If you're speaking to an older person or someone that's higher ranked than you, and there's a whole different system for, like, you know, social ranking, job ranking, military, you know, occupation ranking, education ranking. But if someone outranks you, then it's so ingrained in the language that there's chondema, like respectful speech, and then pandema, which is like short or common speech that you use with your friends and family. And I mean, there's more, it gets more complicated than that, but what the fuck, hold on. Oh. this is fun. So I get messages about the social media accounts I made for Hoogkin Ban, and I get messages. It's Hoogkin, you have 9 new notifications, which is funny because it's Hoogkin. It's like, hey, black person, you have messages. But what was I saying? Ah, damn, let me fix this. All right. So the hierarchy. So yeah, basically that's pretty much it. There's the way you conjugate the verbs is it matters, because if you're speaking to someone that outranks you, you have to use, you know, chondemo. You have to use very, you know, like long form type thing. So, and they bow. So you're like, all right, bowing and using proper. So you can tell in a conversation between two people who outranks the other person, like by, and like I said, it can be by age or occupation or position, et cetera. So yeah, it was crazy. So we walk out into that little plaza and it's just an entire, you know, smorgasbord, a fucking gaggle of drunk businessmen, and they're all just, I can't remember what day of the week, it was a weekday for sure, but it's just, that's normal culture, and then people go to work the next day. Oh, and their fucking subways are incredible. They're so clean. Oh, they're so clean. They're so nice. People get packed in there, though. It's like, it's kind of weird. I guess as Americans, because we're like, people be like, no, you don't touch me. Not, don't, if you're a stranger, you don't touch me. But there, when everyone's like, no, we all got to get to wherever we're going. So like they'll have people that push that, when the car, subway car or whatever, is a full, they'll have people that stand outside and push everyone in. Like, you know, when you're packing your suitcase and you got more stuff in there than fits comfortably, and then you have to like smush it in there and then sit on top to zip it shut. That's what these people do. They fucking smush it, everyone in there, so you're just like squished in there like all tight and shit, so that everyone can get in there. And it's, no one's like, oh my god, what are you, people are touching, blah blah blah. No, they're just like mission oriented. They're like, hey, we all gotta get to the next destination, and this is the most effective way to do it. It's fucking sardine us in here. Oh yeah, so I guess part of, so I started out going there. So being black in Korea, that's a whole nother thing. I gotta want to even talk about it too, but so Korean, I mean, so it's a small country and it's very homogeneous, and so most Korean people, and it's probably even different now than when I was there, because I was there in, I think, 2009, so it's been over 10 years, so there's probably been huge, like, cultural kind of changes, like the younger people, because even when I was there, the younger people, so yeah, the easy way to say is, like, Koreans are super racist, but they're like I said, the culture, they don't let's see, so like personal relationship is very important in Korea, especially like familial things, so friends and family, and people don't, like, really go out, and I'm talking in generalizations and in the past, because, like I said, I haven't been there in like 10 years. But my experience has been that people, you know, they really don't go out to find strangers or meet strangers or bring strangers into their circle. It's like you kind of get, you network through the people that you know. So, you know, personal relationships are a precious commodity in a way. And I think that also kind of goes into that whole, the hierarchy of, like, being respectful. So knowing who is who and where you fit, and, you know, it's so they don't want to, like, just jump people into that. So you build relationships that way through people that you know. I was saying that to say that the easy thing to say is, like, oh wow, super racist, but they're just very close-knit, I guess. And a lot of people haven't had a lot of experience with people that, one, aren't in their own little group of people they already know, and then especially foreigners. Yeah, it's got to be different now, because even when I was there, the young people, we had a homestay family, so, like, we stayed with a Korean family, so I stayed with a family that you know, went over there to do, like, the kind of exchange program or immersion program thing. We each stayed with a Korean family that were, you know, alumni of the school. And I'm pretty sure they picked, I'm sure in their form where they apply for whatever students that they say, like, I'm sure they choose, like, yeah, I would like this race of student, or I'm okay with this race of student. Because I remember one of our other buddies, he stayed with the family he stayed with. They would not stop telling him how much they love black people. And they're like, oh, damn, I don't want to say his name, but I'll call him Junior. So they're like, Junior, yeah. Obama Jr. And they're like showing pictures of Barack Obama, like, oh, I love Obama, and loved anime too, and then talking about black people, how much they love black people. And then so another example too is, so my boy No Juhyun, he's waiting for the an old man followed him into the subway, so he's going down to catch the subway to come to class, and this old man follows him. He's just walking with him, like, he just looking at him, following him. He walks in the thing, not, you know, not like threatening or anything, I mean, he's just an old little dude, but then he's standing super close to my buddy, and my buddy said he just, like, reached out because he's just looking at his skin, like, on his arm, and he reaches out. And he said he just, like, lightly touched his arm and kind of, like, stroked his skin like he was, like, petting a unicorn, I guess. And he was, the guy was like, oh, so beautiful. Oh, your skin so beautiful. And everybody's like, oh, yeah, thank you. And the guy, I guess, he's like, was talking, and he's crazy good at Korean, right? So he starts speaking Korean and blows the dude's mind. And he's just like so happy. He's like, yeah. So the dude's like thanking him and stuff. Maybe I'm telling the story wrong. Maybe I'm adding things. But I know for a fact this part happened where the dude came up, followed him in there, touched his skin, told him he had beautiful skin. That part's I remember for sure. The rest maybe I'm filling in. But anyways, the part of the point of me saying that is it was fun and interesting, you know, to be there. So it's, my whole life I've been, you know, I'm a third culture kid. My mom came from the Philippines. I grew up in the best way to describe it. If you've seen the movie, there's two movies. If you've seen, that Sandra Bullock movie, The Far Side, or not The Far, The, is it The Far, fuck, The Blind Side, or, Me, Myself, and Irene with, fucking Jim Carrey. that's like me. That's me. So I've never been in a place where I fit in, where it was like, oh yeah, everybody else is just like me kind of thing, or I'm just like everybody else. Everywhere I've gone, I'm like, I straddle the line of every demographic, I guess, wherever I go kind of, or I stick completely out. But I've never really kind of just fit, except the Marine Corps. Yeah, the Marine Corps is like one of the only places I was like, yeah, I fit in here. Dark green Marine. But, so yeah, third culture kid. Yeah, because my mom immigrated, and then my parents got divorced when I was like 5, and my dad remarried, and so I grew up in like, not in limbo, but in like a kind of in between everywhere. So I never fit in. So I think that's part of, and that's also part of me going back to the name of Hoogkin Ban Salon, where that comes in. It's because, oh, damn it. Hold on. Oh, see, there it is. I bumped into the thing. But yeah. So yeah. Stuck in the middle. Some of the other stuff, and we'll talk about it another point. I grew up in like a super Mormon family. Super Mormon and super Marine. My dad was 26 in the Marine Corps, 26 years. As an officer, and also very devout LDS Mormon. So yeah, I grew up in kind of like, it's probably a lot like growing up in a Korean house. Super strict parents that are never satisfied with any type of performance. So maybe that's part of why I did well in Korean as well. It was normal. Same thing as Marine Corps. It was kind of like, oh yeah, just normal life. But so Hoogkin Ban. So I think, yeah. So that's part of it. Like, because for me, the way I looked at it when we were in C-Ban, like all the kids, all of us. Yeah, I say kids. Yeah, I mean, this was like 12, 13, 15 years ago. I don't know. All of us that were in that class together, or in you know, C-Ban, Hoogkin Ban specifically, we were kind of the, I don't know, outliers maybe? Like we, and part of it too, like my boy Juan Teyu, I think he might have had the highest grades in the class the entire time. But so he was the greatest, performed academically, top performer, but behavior like the worst. And the teachers, they hated it. It scrambled their brains. They couldn't understand it, that he was like such a terrible acting student, but he was so fucking good at Korean. Like like I don't know if this he's a legitimate genius, like tested genius, but at that time I was like, this motherfucker must be cheating. Like, he must have, like, lived in Korea, learned Korean before he came here, and he's just trolling us. Which I could also see. It's possible. I could see him pulling off that long troll. Being, you know, pull it off. Or I'd have to bow to him for that. But, so he, yeah, the teachers, they did not understand, and they tried to get him kicked out of class so many times, but they were not successful. And then also, like I said, he was fucking better. He's top. He's getting better. There's a kid, speaking of Mormons, fucking can't remember his name, but he had gone on a mission, a church mission to Korea. So he spoke Korean already. He lived in Korea for 2 years. And so at first he was a top performer because he already spoke Korean. And eventually my boy Enki Susa, or whatever the fuck his name is, Wanteu, he surpassed him. And that's part of why I also picked, so this name Hoogkin Ban Salon is because, so we were the misfits. We're in Hoogkin Ban. We were like cast out. The teachers were trying to fucking get rid of us, basically. They quarantined us. And, but we still, we were performers, you know, antics. We would do antics and, but also in class. I mean, academically, we performed. So it's that, I guess that's what I'm getting to, is that's where why I call it Hoogkin Ban Salon. So, because, and then salon, yeah, so like I said, originally it was forum, and then I like salon sounds cooler, and Hoogkin Ban Salon I think flows better than Hoogkin Ban Forum, because it's, you know, a gap. I want it to be kind of like a gathering or a place to collect different kinds of ideas and thoughts expressed in various mediums, you know, spoken, written, musical, like whatever there are, whatever mediums people can express themselves in. So I want it to be kind of a large discussion, like a dynamic series of expressions between people that are not, you know, I guess, you know, center of the road, color in the lines kind of people that don't, you know, the different ideas and expressions that don't get, you know, heard as often or as loudly just because, you know, the teachers don't like their behavior, you know, that kind of thing. So maybe, I want to say that sums it up, but I don't know if I said that in a straight line that makes any sense. So I don't know that I summed anything up. But yeah, that's pretty much Hoogkin Ban Salon. It's meant to be a collection of ideas and people. And it's, you know, I guess a bit ambiguous and nebulous of a explanation, but that's also, I want it to be able to, you know, catch the things that you wouldn't expect to, you know, capture, because I don't want to be like, well, it's gonna be this exact thing, because that fucking limits out everything else. It's too narrow for me. And if you haven't noticed, my mind works in fucking circles, being limited to thinking in a straight line just for other people fucking drives me nuts. And so I guess maybe this is partially therapy. So it's therapeutic. So I try to, you know, speak and write for my own mindset, or for the way my own mind works, and instead of having to try to translate everything into something else for other people or for a specific format so that somebody else can consume it. Because I mean, it's like, all right, if you don't have the time to try to understand it or figure it out, that's fine. You know what I mean? I mean, I feel like I have wasted so many hours of my life trying to fit into something that other people understand, or fucking just keeping my mouth shut because people are only interested in sort of their own reductionist type calculations, because it takes too much effort for them to try to think about something from another point of view, or even it's offensive to some people to be like, oh, I'm looking at this from another standpoint. Like, people are offended by differences of opinion, which, like, I get it. Like, we have emotional reactions to things, but because I mean, I have them too, but it's a thing that I'm working on to not make my emotions my identity, or to tie an emotion to the idea that it's a fact. Like, I feel like people come at things like, oh, I don't like the way I feel when I see that. Here's the easy one. Like, I feel like, and I'll say, because when I growing up, like, I grew up super conservative Mormon Marine Corps family. So for me, I don't know if it's inherent to it, but for me, kind of like being homophobic was like, it just kind of built fit. You know what I mean? I don't ever remember, no one in my family ever went on like rants about, oh, the gay agenda or stuff like that. But it was definitely, you know, taught that, it's supposed to be a man and a woman, that's one man, one woman, that's what love is, blah, blah, blah. And then you get married under the eyes of God, and that's what, you know, the pinnacle achievement of men and women is to combine themselves under the eyes of God and procreate to bring more children of God and blah, 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 all that stuff. So I feel like a lot of people also, they're like, oh, two dudes kissing, oh, that's gross, I don't like how that feels. So that's how I know it's wrong, because I have a feeling about it, like a strong feeling, so that makes it not right. So I feel like that's where a lot of people come at, you know, issues and ideas, especially stuff, you know, that gets fucking politicized, like, you ain't stupid. I mean, I guess it's not stupid, but people have different opinions with things like vaccines. People are like, no, you should do it, shouldn't do it, and people get super emotional about it because they have some personal experience or some sort of personal investment in it. So then that becomes their identity, and then any opposing view is an attack on their identity, which they feel is an attack on them as a person. So then they treat it like they're being physically attacked, and then it fucking spirals from there. So I feel like people should be able to disagree and still be friends. Like, I've had, like, my boy No Juhyun, we used to fucking sit up drinking, just talking shit. And that, back then, his conversations that we had, kind of, I would say going back and forth. It's not even going back and forth. It's not like debating. It's like, we felt differently about things, or we had different feelings. And sometimes they weren't even opposing feelings. They were just different points of view about the same thing. And we would fucking just sit up for hours talking about it. And that's kind of part of, like, years ago, I was thinking I wanted to trying to figure out how to start something kind of like a Hoogkin Ban Salon to record our conversations, because I didn't have a lot of conversations with people that were like that, where it's, because it's usually like very, one person's like, oh, I have this view, you have that view, so I'm going to try to convince you of why what I'm thinking is right. But when No Juhyun and I would talk, would be like, oh, well, this is what I think, and like, oh, maybe I don't even know why I think this. And then we would try to, like, we would talk back and forth about, oh, I wonder where that comes from, and figure out, like, kind of the root of why we felt the way about certain things. And at the end, it wasn't like, oh, we tallied up the score to be like, oh, well, see, I made more points, or you made, it's kind of like, oh, wow, yeah, I didn't think of it that way. I mean, and we didn't always end up saying, oh, yeah, I didn't think about it that way, now I do think about it that way. But no, I mean, I felt like a lot of times, like, oh, yeah, I never even thought to think of it that way. And that, then I kind of evaluate why I think about things the way I do, and I kind of apply that going forward to other things. So learning about different people's different points of view or opinions helps me to evaluate what I know about myself. So it doesn't for me, it's not about proving what I feel is right or proving what I believe is right or proving somebody wrong or that something like that. It's more about kind of learning about other people and ultimately about myself too and my interactions with them. And I don't know, I feel like a lot of people can benefit from that because every conversation these days, it seems like it turns into a fucking someone. Every time you start talking, you have to draw a fucking line in the sand, and no one's, everyone is like, oh, we need unity, we need to be together, but everyone's divvying up teams and like, oh well, I'm on this team and you're not on this team, trying to make peace and unity, but it's very important for me to have a very distinct identity and to give you a very distinct identity and label. So I mean, it's just like, it's, you know, shortcuts, reductionist fucking simple conclusions. It's just a shortcut. There's a good TED talk I have to look up. I don't know, I did write her name down. Fuck, I don't know. It's Vic Shadeva, or I think it's Shedeva. Vicksheedeva. But she talks about how we're all cognitive misers, because we don't want to waste our time trying to figure out, to understand what other people, or to understand things in a different point of view. I think I'm getting close to an hour, so I'm gonna cut it off here soon. But we're getting a. About 50 minutes. All right. So anyway, so she talks up. Gosh damn, I tangled up. I shaza. So what the fuck? She talks about how. So. It's easier to kind of like work off assumptions than have to, you know, because like in each interaction, it's easier to kind of work off the assumptions that were built on previous interactions instead of treating each new interaction as, you know, a new interaction and with basically limitless possibilities. Which, yeah, that would be time consuming and exhausting. And that's why we do it as humans. That's why our brains work that way, so that we're able to, because otherwise we would just be like fucking meditating all day long in each interaction kind of. So, you know, I mean, it's not a bad thing, but it's also something that we should be aware of. And, fuck, I had one other thing that I was going to say connected to that, but whatever. I forgot. So, damn, I derailed myself. But anyways, yeah. So all those things that I said, those are what Hoogkin Ban Salon is supposed to be about. Nothing and everything. Damn, there goes my mind. Oh, what is that song, the Pixies? But anyways, yeah, hopefully I figure out how to get that song that Wante you did to play at the beginning, or maybe I'll put it here at the end. I don't know, I'll put it in here somewhere because it's good. Then I'll figure out about those videos of Stress Breaker, putting those in there too. But yeah, yep, there we go. I derailed myself and fucking my ADD brain isn't coming back. So I'm gonna cut it off here. Thanks and shibar kisekya. Oh, I remembered one more thing. I just want to give a shout out to my boy Wante Yu, his girl. This isn't a paid promotion, this is just a shout out because it's something that I found helpful for me. She makes so it's Apothecali, A-P-O-T-H-E Callie.com. ApothecCallie.com. She makes tinctures. And the one I've been taking is the something with sleep. It's like ZZZZ at the end. But it's to help sleep. And I feel like it works. I ran out last week, and that's another thing about it too. So I ordered some last week, and there was a delay in delivery. I don't know if I'm supposed to say this, but I'm gonna say it as a there was a delay in delivery. So she I ordered the 1 ounce bottle. So she's like, oh, sorry about the delay. She said they're sending a 2 ounce bottle. So shout outs for that. Thank you. But yeah, I feel like so in this little interim of when I haven't had it. Because I take stuff to help sleep anyways, but I feel like it helps me fall asleep faster, and then maybe with dreams, which leads into also, I was asking him about like a lucid dreaming potion or tincture or whatever, so that's in the works at their lab. They're working on a dreaming tincture, and whenever that comes out, I'll give that a shot, and I'll let y'all know how it turned out. And then the other one is it's like a calm, cool, collected or something. It's like a anxiety calming one, and that one's good. I take it like at night, like when I'm done with all my work, and when I'm settling down and winding down for the night. And same thing, I feel like it helps kind of even me out from the day, because I fucking, you know, working and going to school, so my mind, I'm just fucking plugged in, fucking cranking away all day long. And then it helps a little wind down before the lay down, before I go to bed. So check them out. Like I said, it's not an advertisement or a paid thing or anything. It's just something cool that somebody I know is doing, or I guess by proxy, because I know Wanteyu, and they sleep in the same bed, so it's like she's my sister-in-law, I guess. But yeah, someone I know doing something cool that I like, and that I feel like it works for me. So if you don't want to check it out, don't check it out. But if you're curious, or you're into that holistic, natural, healthy type of stuff, and small business, helping small business people, and blah 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 blah, go for it. Take some. But oh, this is good. Oh, Aigoo, this is good. But anyways, like I said, fuck you later.